Good morning boys, we will continue the exercise number 5.2. I told you already this is just like, it is not a just like 5. Exercise number 5.1, but there is a limitations. This is interpolation method. We have two method in interpolations. One is Lagrange's, another one is Newton's. Under the Newton's Gregory's formula method, we have two types. One is forward, another one is backward. So when you will use forward formula and backward formula, it is depends upon the question. Clear? We have two types under the interpolation method. One is Lagrange's method, another one is Newton's Gregory's method. So what are the cases that we have to apply this method? When the question is mentioned using Newton's Gregory's method, then you go for that method. In that, we have two subdivisions. One is forward and another one is backward formula. Depends upon the question under the Newton's Gregory's formulas. Clear? And the question is mentioned using Lagrange's, we have only one formula. So, okay, if it is mentioned, then you know how to solve the problem by using either Gregory's forward for Newton's forward formula or backward formula. Clear? Now, so Newton's forward formula, Newton's backward formula, when the question is mentioned by using Newton's Gregory's method, that we have to go for it. What is another one possibility is, if it is mentioned using Lagrange's, you have to use only Lagrange's. When the method is not mentioned in the question, how do you find out which one is suitable for the given questions? That you have to find out. How do you find out? Just you have to see that X, you have the tabular column X and Y. They will give the data like this, X and Y. When the difference in X are same, for example, 5, 10, 15, 25 and 30. When the difference of these two are same, see 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. You can use Newton's Gregory's formula and also Lagrange's. Both method you can use. Clear? But actually this is meant only for what? Gregory's, that is Newton's formula. Whether it is forward or backward, it depends upon the question. When you go to the exercise, you will see that. Clear? So when the difference under X are same, then you go for Newton's formula. When the difference are different, like 5, 15, then 20, 30, 45 and so on. See, the difference is not in equal size. Difference is different. That X data comes on a different size. Therefore, in this case, you have to apply Lagrange's formula. Clear? When the difference are same in size under X, Gregory's Newton's formula. When the size under X are different, see here 5, 10, 5, 10. So, the size of the X data are different. Therefore, you have to use Lagrange's formula. So only these two conditions, no other conditions by using the either Newton's formula or Lagrange's formula. These, you can solve this problem either by using Lagrange's or Newton's, you will get same answer. But when the method name is mentioned in the question paper, you have to follow only the particular method. When the method is not mentioned in the question, you have to identify whether you have to apply the Newton's formula or Lagrange's formula. When you apply the Newton's forward formula, backward formula, when the difference under the X data are same size, see difference between 5 and 10 is 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. So therefore, you can use Newton's formula. But whereas in the second model, here difference is 10, there 5, 10, then 15. So difference are not in same size. Therefore, you have to take which formula? Lagrange's formula. That's all. That's the concept. So, without calculator, you cannot solve this exercise. So, I am going to do only with the tabular column. then I will substitute in this formula your work to complete those calculations part alone at home by using calculator. Clear? So exercise 5.2, question number 1 and 2 is comes under graph that I will put it, those two problems alone in WhatsApp in our group. Just you have to refer and you started to work it out in the far note itself. Clear? Exercise 5.2, question number 1 and 2, it is based on the graph sheet. So I will send, I will put that those two sums alone in the group. You just copied and write, but remaining problems we will see now. Clear? But you have to use calculator. Without calculator, please don't do it. Clear? I am not going to complete all the problems because I did not bring calculator. So I am going to stop the previous steps of the last answer. So you have to simplify by using the calculator, write down that answer. Clear? So now using Newton's forward interpolation formula, find the cubic polynomial. It is mentioned very clearly using forward interpolation formula. So what is forward interpolation formula? That we have, you must see the question number 3. We have formula, but there is a forward formula, backward formula. When I started to work out the problems, in that itself I write what is the forward formula and backward formula. Forward formula. So before you have to use this one, you have to write form the terminal column, that is xy, under x 0 1 2 3. What is given? See, what is given under y? That is f of x is nothing but y. So under y, what is given? 1, 2, 1, 10. Now you have to go for delta y naught. What is delta y naught? How do you find delta y naught? In the previous essay we did 10 minus 1, 9. 1 minus 2, minus 2. 2 minus 1, 1. Be careful. 10 minus 1 is 9, 1 minus 2 is minus 1. Be careful. 2 minus 1, 1. So be careful of subtracting this y column. 10 minus 1, 9. 1 minus 2, minus 1. 2 minus 1, 1. Then 9 minus. So next you have to write delta square y naught. 9 minus of minus 1, 9 plus 1 is equal to how much? 10. 9 minus of minus 1, that is 10. Then minus 1, minus 1, that is minus 2. Delta cube y naught. 10 minus of minus 2, how much? Plus 12. So you have to do up to, you will get single number in the terminal column. That only we did in the previous exercise. Question number 3, I think so. Clear? So, be careful of working out the problems. 10 minus 1, 9. 1 minus 2 is minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. 9 plus 1 is 10. Then minus 1 is minus 2. 10 minus of minus 2 is 12. So, you have to complete this tabular column. Now it is given very clearly forward formula. To find forward formula, guys, listen, this is the forward formula. That is y is equal to y naught plus n in n by n factorial into delta y naught. Just you have to write n into n minus 1 by 2 factorial into delta square y naught plus n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 by 3 factorial into delta cube y naught. So we have up to delta cube y naught. You have to stop up to this. If it is given delta power 4, then you have to write n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into n minus 3 by 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 factor, therefore 4 factorial into delta power y naught. If it is given 5, then you have to write plus n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 n minus 3 n minus 4 y factorial delta power 5 y naught. You have to extend the formula depends upon the how many columns that you are using. Clear? So this is the formula to find Newton's, what a formula? Forward formula. If forward formula, this is formula. Backward, when I comes to the particular problem, I explain. But forward problem is nothing. Just you have to replace minus 1 by plus 1 in all the formulas. N into n plus 1, n into n plus 1, n plus 2, n into n plus 1, n plus 2, n plus 3. But instead of delta, you have to write named y power n. That's all. You have to replace the delta power y. Delta y naught is replaced by nabla yn. That's all. That's the difference for backward formula. Forward formula, n into n minus 1 and so on. It will comes in negative values. Whereas in backward formula, you will get n plus 1, n into n plus 1, n plus 2 and so on. So, this negative will become positive for backward formula and the delta is replaced by nabla yn, not y naught, yn. That's all. That's the difference between the forward formula and backward formula. So, for forward formula, you have only minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, delta y naught, delta square y naught, delta cube y naught, delta power 4 y naught, and so on. Depends upon the question, the column. Clear. Whereas for backward formula, same one, instead of y naught, what will come here? Yn will come. Delta, in the place of delta, will come lambda, nabla y naught. This is n into n plus 1, nabla square yn. That's all. That's the difference by 2 factorial. There is no difference in that. You have to replace this by nabla. In the place of y naught, you have to write yn. In the place of minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, you have to replace plus 1, plus 2. In the place of y naught, you have to write yn. That's all. That's the difference between backward formula, forward formula. Here it is given very clearly using forward interpolation. Therefore, you can use only the forward method. We have the tabular column only up to delta power 3 y naught. So, delta power 4 y naught, not necessary. This is the formula. Now, how to find out n? I know what is delta y naught, delta square y naught, delta cube y naught. That you can easily find out from the tabular column. But question is, you have to find out what is n. What is n? X minus x naught by h. This is the formula to find n. What is x? This x will be given in the question. But in the question number 3, x value is not given. Therefore, keep x as it is. X value is not given in the question number 3. Therefore, you keep x as it is. If it is the x value is given in the question, you have to replace x by the given value. Clear? So, x is not given in the question number 3. Therefore, you have to write x as it is. X naught. This is x naught, x1, x2, x3. This is y naught, y1, y2, y3. Clear? X naught. Don't think that 0 means you can address x naught. Always first data under x is x naught, x1, x2, x3. Y naught, y1, y2, y3. So this is y naught and this is x naught, x1, x2, x3, y1, y2, y3. So x minus, what is your x naught? 0. What is your h? Difference in x. What is the size? What is the difference between the data under x? 1, 1, 1. Therefore, h is replaced by 1. How do you find out h? The difference between the data. 0 to 1 difference, 1. 1 to 2 difference, 1. 2 to 3 difference, 1. So, when the difference are same, you can apply Newton's formula just now explained. Clear? When the size between the x data are same, you can use Newton's formula. That's why they mentioned in the question number 3 itself, use Newton's forward formula. Clear? So, x is, I don't know what is x, keep it as it is. X naught is replaced by 0. I just now find what is h, difference in x, not in y. Difference in x is stands for h, not the difference of y data. So, difference in x data is h, that is 1. So, x minus 0 is x, x by 1 is x. Now, I know what is n. That's all. It is forward formula. For forward formula, you have to replace delta y naught, delta square y naught and delta cube y naught from the outside. This is for forward. This is only for forward formula. For backward, you have to start from the down onwards. 10, 9, 10 and the same number. There is no difference to take the final number for both forward as well as backward. For backward formula, you have to replace nabla yn and nabla yn, nabla square yn, this is nabla cube yn. So you go far from down onwards for which formula? Backward formula. For forward formula, you have to take from the upside. Clear? So this is delta y naught, this stands for delta square y naught, this stands for delta cube y naught. If you go for backward formula, this stands for nabla yn, nabla square yn, nabla cube yn. So depends upon the question, you have to select nabla or delta, forward or backward formula. Now you have to replace all the informations in this formula and simplify, you will get required one. So y naught, what is your y naught? 1. So y is equal to 1 plus n is replaced by x by 1. Delta y naught is how much? 1 into 1 plus n x minus 1. 2 factorial is 1 into 2. Delta square y naught is minus 2 plus x minus 1 x minus 2 by 1 into 2 into 3, because 3 factorial is 1 into 2 into 3. Delta cube y naught is given as 12. So now you can simplify. 2 3s are 6, you will go 2 times in 12. 2 2 get cancelled. Here no possibilities. Therefore, what will be that your answer? Your answer is now y is equal to 1 plus x. You just multiply with minus sign, minus x square minus x plus into minus minus, then I take x inside the bracket, x square minus x plus, this will be x into x square minus x into x minus 2 into 2. Clear? So just you have to simplify, you will get required answer. Yes? Just you have to take minus inside the bracket, then multiply these two, then you have to multiply these all the four terms by 2, simplify with the like terms, you will get required answer. So after this is a simple algebraic method that you know already in the lower classes. Just you have to simplify, now you will get required cubic polynomial, because power of x is what? 3.
So just you have to apply the basic algebraic multiplications rule what you studied in the lower classes, you will get required answer. This is called cubic polynomial. Why it is called cubic polynomial? Because the degree of this polynomial is how much? That is called cubic polynomial. Yes, sir. So this is very simple. What you think, you have to memorize the formula. Here I am going to come. So you have to work out all the remaining problems by using only the calculator. So I am going to do only the 3/4 of the problems. So the remaining 1/4 of the part that you have to do is very far. Calculator. Clear? Now you go to sum number 4. Sum number 4, that is the population of the city in the census taken once in 10 years is given below. Estimate the population in the year 1955. So you take here as x and the next one as population is y. Under x we have 1951, 1961, 1971 and 1981. So the population in max is given 35, 42, 58, 84. Now they are asked to estimate the population of each year 1955. So x is 1955 because you are asked to find out what is the population in the year of 1955 in the slice between 51 to 61. So you have to take x equal to, but in the previous question we do not have any information about x, therefore you take x as this. But here you are asked to estimate the population in the year of 1955. So x equal to 1955. Now see that signs under the x letters 10, 10, 10. So the difference in 51 to 61, 10, 61 to 71 is also 10, 71 to 81 is represent 10. So the class size is 10, therefore you can choose only Newton's formula. The question is whether Bhaagwan formula or factor formula. How do you select whether it is father or factor? Depends upon the x. What is the difference x? 1955. It comes under first half or second half? 1955. It comes to the first half. In this first half, you take forward formula. If it is 1975, it comes in the second, that is second half. In this case, you go for backward formula. Backward formula is just by set. In the place of n minus 2, you have write n plus 1, n plus 2, then draw by n. Here 70, it is given 75, you can take backward formula because 75 lies in the second half. When the data comes in the second half, you take backward formula. When the data comes in the first half, you have to take forward formula. Now, if x is given 1955, it is first half, that we can use forward formula before we have to find out x. That is n, x minus x naught by h. What is your x? 1955. What is your x naught? This is x naught and this is y naught. X naught is 1951.10. The difference in x is 10. So 55 minus 51, that is 4 by 10 is equal to 0.4. So what is the n? 0.4. So once you know what is n, then we have to find out the table term delta y naught. How we find delta y naught? Subtract these two. 84 minus 58. 84 minus 58. 14. 14 minus 8, 6. 7 minus 5, 2. So 26. 58 minus 42. 8 minus 2, 6. 5 minus 4, 1. Then 42 minus 35. 42 minus 35. 3 equals, so 7. So be careful when you subtract these two, you please do use calculator and check. Don't simply copy from the board. Use calculator and simplify. Next, delta square y naught, again subtract. 26 minus 16, 10. 16 minus 7, how much? 9. Then delta cube y naught, 10 minus 9, how much? So I got 1. So you have to simplify, leave a single number. 16 minus 7, 9, you check. Correct or wrong? 7 plus 9, 7 plus 9, 16. So your answer is correct. So be careful. When you do this one, please use calculator. You subtract from down onwards. 84 minus 58, 58 minus 42, 42 minus 35. Just you have to subtract and proceed, you will get answer. So after that, already we showed that you can use only which formula? Forward formula. Forward formula. So you just see that. Now I am going to write the formulas, that is y is equal to y naught plus n pi 1 factorial into factorial into delta square y naught, then we have 2 cube, so you have right plus n into n minus 1, n minus 2 by 3 factorial into delta cube y naught. So you have to write the formula depends upon the power. If it is delta power 4, you have to write one more, that is n into n minus 1, n minus 2 by 4 factorial into delta power y naught. Here, so now this is the required formula for this problem. Just you have to substitute. I told you already, I am going to substitute only the values. Remaining part you are going to account by using the formula. Y naught, what is y naught? 35 plus what is the n? 0.4. 1 factorial is 1 into delta y naught. It is normal formula. You have to substitute that number in the first part. If it is better formula, you have to substitute from the double one notes. Into delta y naught, that is 7 plus n 0.4. 0.4 minus 1 by 2 factorial is 1 into 2 delta square y naught 9 plus n 0.4. 0.4 minus 1, 0.4 minus 2 by 1 into 2 into 3 into what is the delta cube y naught? 1. So how to simplify? You take this one separately, I tell you only one. For example, I have okay. I simplify only this problem alone. The remaining problems I will write the thanks after the stage. Then you have to use a formula later and simplify. Clear? So now this alone I simplify. 30, that is 0.487. 2.8. Take the next part, this alone, 0.4 into 0.-1, how much? 1.0, 0.4, that is 0.6, 0.1 is minus 6, greater number is minus, therefore you subtract 0.-6 in the calculator, some of the points they will do like this, 1-0.4. So what is given here, in the same process you have to go in confidence, 0.4 minus 1, 0.4 minus 1, which will give you minus 0.6, minus 0.6 into 9 by 2. So you simplify. So if you simplify, you will get 1.0.
Clear? So don't, even this
start to get to my answer, you get, I put already some thought pattern will give correct answer, some thought pattern will not give the correct answer. So, how I do those problems? First, you have to add the positive numbers, then you have to subtract the negative values. You get the required one. Clear? So, this is the process. This is very simple, but be careful of doing the competition part. If you miss any one active side, then you get everything is getting strong, so you get maximum 1 or 2 marks for 5 out of 5 marks. Clear? So this is not only 5 marks. So if it is smaller one, depends upon the length of